For me, how the cancer affected my life and my lifestyle was it prevented me from continuing on this momentum that I had created in my life of going out and exploring, adventuring, you know, doing my outdoor ed, and traveling. Traveling was huge for me. And that's something that I had a really hard time kind of dealing with, because I told myself I'm never going to travel again. My life is over. So if anything, weirdly enough, the cancer gave me stability, because suddenly I had to stay in one place. So when I was diagnosed, when I came to Ottawa, I was living with a friend, found a place with a good friend of mine. And I was diagnosed, I had to move back in with my parents. That sucked. They were great though, they were great. I was very lucky to have such supportive parents in my life. You know, they put their life on hold, you know, while I was putting my life on hold. You know, they were with me from the get-go, in the trenches. You know, they're the ones, they were sitting next to me when we got the prognosis, and they were the ones driving me to my radiation appointments. Yeah. So they were great. Very, very, very supportive. And one thing that I did struggle with was that idea that I lost my independence, I lost my autonomy. And I expressed that to my parents, and I said, look, I know that I'm going through this hard time right now, but, you know, I still want to keep teaching in September. I still think I can make it work. So I would like to move out. And this was maybe 3 months, 3-4 months after my diagnosis. And they helped me. They wanted to keep me, of course, you know, and a parent has this risk, you know, they live trauma. That's what it was. They lived a trauma. And they want to keep you. They want to protect you. That's the role of a parent. But they always put my wishes and my needs and my wants ahead of their own. So when I said that I wanted to move out, for their first initial reaction is like, "Ugh, no, you're staying here. You're staying with us." And then, you know, I gave them a couple hours. And then I said, I still want to move out. You know, I love you guys, but I need to regain my independence. You know, especially if I don't have that much time left. I wouldn't want to live the next year or however much I have, you know, pretending that I'm back as a teenager, right? I'm an adult, I'm not, and they were responsive to that.